Shalom Aleichem, everybody. Hope all is well. The Rebbe says something very interesting. He says, and he actually emphasizes to publicize this, that we should really be involved in telling this to people. And this message to the world, this mission that we have to join, is to understand that each positive deed, each good deed we do for Hashem, it is as if we're doing a favor for the Abishter, for Hashem. Hashem is beyond infinite. Hashem is perfect. But he allows us the opportunity to give back to him, so to speak. Hashem created us to give us an opportunity to serve him, because serving God is the greatest opportunity of all. Why is that so? Well, in truth, our greatest pleasure, Hashem's greatest pleasure is to give. Hashem's nature, Hashem is good, and his nature of the good one is to give. Hashem wants to give his kindness, wants to spread his kindness on others. But before the world was created, there was just Hashem. Even now, there's still Hashem, but so to speak, Hashem creates us so that he could bestow his goodness upon someone else. And we're the children of Hashem that he wants to spread his goodness upon, to shine his light upon. So, how does he give to us? How does Hashem give to us? By giving us the greatest opportunity. The opportunity to give back to him. And when we follow the Torah and the mitzvahs, and we treat each other with respect and with love, we are giving back to Hashem, so to speak. And that's the greatest mission of all. We're doing a favor for Hashem. So when you look at serving Hashem in that respect, in that way, you realize that the beautiful thing about serving God is not that you have to and you're gonna get, and then if you don't, this is gonna happen. It's true that it's serious, and when a person, God forbid, doesn't serve God, there are repercussions, and it is a serious matter, and we have to encourage each other to serve God as much as possible. But the deeper way of serving God is out of love and out of fear of not fear of punishment. That's a lower level, but a higher level is fear of hurting God's feelings, hurting God, so to speak. Because realizing the beautiful opportunity that's on the line and what we risk losing when we don't serve God, that is really the deeper way of serving God. So with that being said, let us increase in this mission to bring Mashiach. The Rebbe always said that there's a war. There's a war between the good inclination, the good in the world, and the evil. The good inclination and the evil inclination. And we have to go to war against our own evil within us. And when we do that, we will bring Mashiach. Each mitzvah we do can be the difference maker to bring Mashiach. So when you do one extra mitzvah, we know that each mitzvah causes another mitzvah to happen. So when you do one mitzvah, another person in the world, another Jew in the world is going to do a mitzvah. And then someone else and so on and so forth. It's like a fire that continuously spreads. And the more you give, the more you get. What's interesting about the nature of fire is the more fire gives, the more it expands. So too, when we serve Hashem, the more we give to others, the more we get greater. The more we make Hashem's name greater throughout the world. So let's all try to do one extra mitzvah here, one extra mitzvah there. And those can be the difference makers, not just those. Even one could be the difference maker that tips the scales. Never underestimate the power of one good deed that you do, because that could be the difference maker that all of a sudden activates the redemption, and we're now living in the days of Mashiach. So let us encourage others. And that is something exciting when you see it as a war, as like a mission to bring down the evil within each and every one of us, and purify the impurity within us and purify our hearts. And when we do that, Mashiach will appear. It could be any moment now. And the Rebbe says something very interesting, where the Rebbe quotes Brachos. Where in Brachos, the Masechet in the Talmud, where it talks about how the war that a person fights within himself and the war that goes on between a home, between family, is far more serious than the war of Gog and Magog, the ultimate war. That the war that someone goes through in his own house, with his family, with his own self, with his own soul, the battle a person goes against his own evil inclination is far greater than any war we can imagine in the physicality. So what do we do about this? Just like in a war, if you're fighting a war, if two nations are fighting a war against each other, the nation can't just be relaxed and let the war take its course. No, if you want to take down the enemy, you're going to have to keep sending troops and hit them and hit them and hit them. Of course, you're going to have to recalculate, and you're going to have to, you know, heal, and you're going to have to refuel, and you have to calculate, and you can't overdo yourself. But at the end of the day, you're going to have to keep inciting the enemy. You're going to have to keep striking the enemy. You're going to have to keep them uncomfortable. Because if you give them too much time to be comfortable, they're going to get comfortable and attack you even harder. So even when you're refueling, you're going to have to always launch attacks at them. You're going to always have to disturb them and smash their equipment and break their plans and cause them pain and scare them and incite against them. That's how you win a war. So too, and how much more so, when we go to war against the evil inclination, against the Satan, Satan. The Satan is in the world. There's evil in the world. But mainly it's, what do we have the greatest influence on? Our own selves and the ones who we're close to. But even the ones that we're close to, we have to do it in a loving way. But when it comes to within ourselves, we have to be strong to overcome the evil within each and every one of us. And of course, there are tzaddikim in the world, and there are people who have fully turned over the evil within them. But now that Mashiach, until Mashiach appears, it means there's still more work to do. It means that one extra thing you could do can be the difference maker. When we realize that actually is the greatest opportunity, that a Baal Tshuva brings down this greatest light, because Hashem knows that it's challenging. A person should never say, wow, it's so hard to do a mitzvah, it's challenging. No, the fact that it's difficult sometimes, the fact that sometimes we have the evil inclination that tries to stop us from doing a good thing, that shows the preciousness of this opportunity that's in front of us. If serving God was always so easy, it wouldn't be worth as much. The fact that it requires effort, it causes Hashem pleasure. And when we work for something, it actually is for our greatest benefit. Because Hashem made us in a sense, in a way where we desire to toil, we want to work. When we work for something, we appreciate it all the more so. So when we work for God, when we get involved, and we sign up to enlist in the army of the Lord, then we start to enjoy serving God. We enjoy the effort, and we realize that our efforts are giving to Hashem. And each and every one of us, we have the ability to serve God and to give back to Hashem. And when we help others, imagine the pleasure it causes Hashem. That when we help His children, when we help His other children, we get them involved. We connect others to Hashem. How great is that? And how much pleasure does that cause God? And in truth, how much pleasure does it cause us to be able to give to Hashem? So please, let us join the army of God, the army of Hashem, that the Rebbe always said, the army of God, Tzivas Hashem. We could grow and we could get others to do good deeds. I want to make this video, the comment section, a center for all the good deeds you guys do. You've been commenting your beautiful deeds in the comment section below, and it's been making me unbelievably happy, and I look forward to seeing many more comments. Please comment in this video, share with others the good deeds that you're performing. Even share the good deeds that you maybe got someone else to perform. And with that, we're going to increase and spread the fire of the Torah. We're going to publicize Hashem's name. We're going to make Hashem's name famous throughout the world. And all the nations are going to turn to God. All the leaders are going to bow to God as prophesied. So let today be the day. Increase. Let us do all one or two or three or infinite more extra deeds to the best of our abilities and be happy. Increase in our joy. Every moment we're happy, we channel in the divine light into the world at an infinitely greater degree. Let us increase in joy and trust in God, in faith in God. Let us increase in our confidence that God is going to deliver us. When we show God that we're confident that he's going to deliver us, we arouse a mercy from above, and we cause God to want to prove Himself to us. Because when we show our trust in Him, He wants to deliver us. He doesn't want to disappoint us, God forbid. So let us increase. Let us invite God to reveal Himself to the whole world. Please share this message with others and comment your good deeds, whether it's a chapter of Psalms, whether it's another Bible verse you recited, whether it's a prayer you said to God, whether it's a good deed you performed for someone, maybe you said some charity, maybe you learned something interesting, maybe you smiled at another person. Let me know. Thank you. God bless you all.